And I think it's going to be a long, long time. The touchdown brings me around again to find Suki.
I've never used words for that line. What is it? What is
it? I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh, no. I'm a Rocket Man. Rocket Man. Burning out a fuel up hair alone.
I wish I learned all the words. Thank you, Scott Stanford, for teaching that.
And I think it's going to be a long, long time.
I got that part.
I know. I used to think it's burning out of something. Burning out of fuel. No, it's burning out of fuel up here alone.
Up here alone. Okay.
Yes. And then he says.
I never really knew it. I have to. That's a true confession.
Mars ain't the kind of place to raise your kid.
Act as cold as hell. I got that part.
You know, this is actually quite apropos because it's today is National Sing Out Day.
Is it
and,
really?
Even though we sing every day on the show, it's National Sing Out Day every day on this program.
We're singing in the rain. We sing in the snow. We sing during COVID. We sing all the time.
We have, speaking of national days, when we come up on the other side of the intro, I've got a couple of national days for you that you're going to tell me if they're real or fake.
Okay.
And you're going to let me know which ones are real and which ones are fake. But listen, we got an amazing show. Eugenia Kuzmina is on tonight. She's an actress, model.
Gorgeous. I mean.
Covers. She's in that movie, The Elevator, with Eric Roberts. She plays his wife. Been in a bunch of other movies. Jamie Roberts coming on. He's a comedian, funny as can be. And then later on, we got the New Directions Veterans Choir. They were on America's Got Talent. Former homeless vets, Sook, who all banded together for this amazing choir. We got two of those folks coming on. I've got videos of them. They're going to sing. It's going to be a great show. Philly Kid's going to join us later on, and we are off and running. You ready, babe? It's a Tuesday.
I'm ready to do this. It's Memorial Day weekend. It's almost liftoff time. Let's go.
Come on.
The Suki and Scott Show. The Suki and Scott Show.
This is one of the funnest shows I've ever done.
It's musical. It's magical.
Whoa!
This is a sexy show.
Someone's getting some action.
These larger-than-life personalities are on an exciting new journey as they bring you the Suki and Scott Show.
You guys, I nailed it. You're great. You ask great questions. You listen.
The Suki and Scott Show is your one-stop destination for humor.
You just got George's earwax all over your ears, bud.
Entertainment.
Jesse's girl.
Wonderful.
And optimism.
You guys have such amazing energy.
Let's laugh together.
We'll love him.
The Suki and Scott Show.
Bam. And we're off. Off and running, Suk. Listen.
Guys,
it's already
can you believe that we are like looking at Memorial Day weekend?
Yeah.
I mean, it's a little crazy. A little daunting. I mean, when did this happen?
Yeah, Memorial Day weekend coming right up. And really in honor of that, the New Directions Veterans Choir is going to be joining us later on. Suk, we have so much to do. First of all, listen, I want to say hello to everybody, but I want everybody who's watching us right now, I want you to hit that share button right underneath the show. And I want you to share the show with all your friends. That's what I want you to do. Number two, Philly Kid's Facebook is still down, so he'll be providing some songs for our page. Everybody loves watching Phil sing. He'll be joining us a little later on. But go ahead, Suk. Let's talk to the people before we get going.
We had a friend join us from Illinois telling us how much she loved us, and I'm finding her. Oh, she just went up so quickly. Hi, my name is Mary, and I'm watching you from Lockport, Illinois. I love watching you both. Mary Craig, thank you so much for joining us.
Really? Mary Craig.
Jordan Gray, let's see, Pamela Naseda, Rory Wright, Pam Apolloni, Anna Hoover, Jill Jones, Zoe Marie, Autumn Currier. Everybody's here. Cheryl Hull is here.
Cheryl's always here with us. Another loyal.
Sherry Hetrick, always.
Yeah. But listen, I want everybody who's watching to really just hit the share button underneath and share the show with everybody. As a matter of fact, Suk, you kill 2 minutes. I'm going to do that real quick because I forgot to share us up.
Yeah, share us up.
Let me just see what's
happening.
All right,
so a lot of people are just excited. Donna Freschetto is here as always. Pam Apolloni, Pamela Naseda, Priscilla Ham Witherspoon. A lot of people here. And I just can't believe we're looking at Memorial Day 2021. I just had this moment with myself, like, what? With Scotty and I were talking. I'm like, when did this happen? Like, I'm confused.
Yeah, here I know.
And we're rocking and rolling this weekend. A lot of news happened this weekend, didn't it?
Yeah. A lot of stuff going on. And, you know, what was your biggest takeaway from the weekend? What was the biggest thing that happened as far as you're concerned? Yeah, a lot more drinking, right? Listen, last year at this time, you know, things were really in total disarray.
We were in total disarray.
Fortunately, right now, you know, half of Americans have been vaccinated.
Yeah, and can I tell you something? I went out on Friday night. I just want to share this with everybody. I went out on Friday night with one of my girlfriends. It was her birthday.
Right.
So we went to a local restaurant in the area. You would have thought it was 1999 and we're celebrating the millennial. There were more birthdays in that restaurant. I was like, they just kept coming out with those flaming candles. I'm like, what is going on? I feel like I'm in Las Vegas right now. But everybody was like happy. It feels like the country is turning around. It feels like everything is moving in the right direction. And everybody's just looking good and feeling better. And I think, you know, the weather is really helping that out, you know? So
it's hopefully we get back to complete normalcy. I know they just said here in our area, MetLife Stadium, when the football season comes around, full capacity there for the Jets and Giants. Suk, I wanted to mention, do you remember Izzy Burns? Izzy Burns.
Yeah.
He's from Moscow. What was it? Idaho. Moscow, Idaho. Well, Izzy sent me an email, and she sent it to both of us. She wanted to send us a graduation note, like her graduation announcement. So here's what she sent me. You know, she's graduating Moscow High to Colorado Mesa University. Get ready to jam and listen to great music. And we were invited to the June 12th little party there at the Hungo Dungo Brewing Company.
I want to hang out at the Hungo Dungo Brewing Company.
Yeah. It says feel free to bring instruments or just hang out. So we could bring our instruments, which we don't play. But Izzy Burns, who was fantastic, she wanted me to pass that along to you.
Can I tell you, Izzy Burns is a sweetheart. Totally talented.
Great? Yeah.
Going to study music and something else. She was going to play volleyball too, right?
Yep. Music and volleyball.
Yeah. It's interesting. She's got her boyfriend. I just love Izzy Burns. I think she's just going to be such a superstar.
Yeah.
But, you know, Izzy is just one of the many people that we've been able to connect with and that we've been able to share their amazing talent through the process of what we've created here on the Suki and Scott Show.
Speaking of which, Suk, you know, we created this show a little over a year ago.
Yeah.
And when we first started out, nobody told us that we needed good Wi-Fi. Nobody told us not to use Zoom. Nobody told us to get good cameras. So when we first started out, you know, it wasn't that easy for us.
No.
And in passing through some of our first videos, I'm going to prove it to you because I came across this right here.
You know this song, Suk? I'm making it. I got the chance, I'm taking it.
Did you freeze again?
Suk, you froze again.
Come on, Suk.
Suki, you froze.
Oh, man. I'm sorry, folks. This is too funny, man. Too funny.
Oh, that is great. You guys see her frozen? Chance I'm taking it. No more. Man.
Everybody. Oh, this is great. Hold on.
You guys,
who's back? Where are you, Suk?
Listen, everyone here. I don't know what's happening tonight. It's gonna be my year. I'm as fast as they come. I'm in tune to no one. I've got looks, I got brains, and I'm breaking these chains. I've got the chance.
So did you see how you froze?
I was like this.
Oh, man. I just had a good laugh at your expense.
How funny was that? I mean, look at how beautiful our picture is right now.
Yeah, we've really come a long way.
We've really come a long way.
Listen, you know our what's so funny is that, like, we didn't even know about, like, where we were going to take this show. Like, what were we going to do?
Oh, yeah, no.
Like, were the bananas going to stay on the hammock? I mean, look, my son won a slushy machine this weekend.
Wait, hold on. What do you got back there?
He's got a slushy machine. He won it this weekend.
Oh,
I mean, it's like crazy.
I see that. That's cool. Listen, by the way, you have to keep those bananas fresh now. Those have to be there every time.
The banana on the hammock has turned into like a joke on the Suki and Scott show now.
Who's got a banana on a hammock? You may need to get fake bananas. Suk, just waiting for Jamie Roberts to log in. We should have went with Eugenia since she was here.
Oh, you want to go with Eugenia?
Well, she's not there now. She just left her her thing is up, but she'll be here.
You know what Aaron Meyer says? Through all the technical difficulty, the show always rolled on, you know?
Yeah,
it's
well, listen.
People like you guys have fun. You make COVID bearable. And, you know, it's true. And you know what? Half of these people have been with us from the very beginning. They signed on.
The very beginning, yeah.
And they've been our super fans as we've grown from like, what, 5 viewers to 10 viewers to now 40,000 plus and, you know, 2 million hits, all of the stuff that's happening for us. And it's because of you guys.
Yeah, no, it's unbelievable. Sandra's telling me that Jamie is in there, but I don't see him. So we just need him to, Jamie, if you can hear me, just log in again, because I don't see you up there, buddy. So hopefully he's logged into the right show.
Donna Frischetta cracks me up. She's like, yepers, day one, stuck with y'all. We stuck with
day
you.
Day one.
Jeannie Clay, well, hello, hello, hello. Of course I would never forget about you, Jeannie Clay.
Yep, everybody hello. In the house. And again, listen, we need everybody to share the show. Just hit share, boom. Just hit
Cheryl
the share
Hall.
Button.
Yeah, share the show. Jane Beer, love you all. Roxanne Kinney, we love you all.
Suk, as we said, today is National Sing Out Day. And really, every day, there's like 5 national days. So I'm going to throw a couple up at you. You tell me if these are real or not real. And I'll let you know if you get it right. So here's the first one. Here we go. So here's the first one. National Fruitcake Toss Day. Yes or no?
I'm going to say.
National Fruitcake Toss Day.
Yes.
Yes or no? The answer is yes. National Fruitcake Toss Day is January the 3rd.
I didn't even know. Do people eat fruitcake?
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe you have a friend who you think is a fruitcake and you toss him or her around.
You know what? I was thinking about, is that the fruitcake that you give during the holidays? Is that the cake?
Yeah. It's like
so maybe it makes sense because on January 3rd, by that time, it's been sitting around for a long time. It's turned into a log. So you might as well toss it out. So, yeah. I like that.
Let's see. So here's another one. National Hot Pastrami Sandwich Day.
Yes.
Is that yes or no?
We're from New York. Hot pastrami? Come on. Yeah.
That is on January 14th. You are correct, young lady. You are correct.
Where do you get the best, you know, pastrami sandwich?
The best Lower pastrami side. Sandwich? Listen, I've got a couple delis up in my area, which are
what's
unbelievable.
What's your deli?
Oh, yeah. Remember the deli we had on our morning
show? Yeah. What
was the deli?
Casa del Sol.
Here's another one for you. Tell me if this is real or fake. National Funeral Director and Mortician Appreciation Day.
Sure.
You going yes on that?
I'm
going
to say yes because we have National Broadcaster Day, so why not?
We're right there with funeral directors, so why not? The answer is yes. March 11th is National Funeral Director and Mortician Appreciation Day.
When you really need them, they're there for you, the funeral.
All right, Suk, now you as a woman, you know you use hair ties a lot, right? Ponytails, things like that. And I'm sure growing up and now you probably lose them all the time.
All the time.
Right? You lose them all the time. So, Hair Tie Remembrance Day, yes or no?
No.
Hair Tie Remembrance Day, yes or no? You going with no?
I'm
going
to go with no.
Are you going with no, but it should be a national holiday?
I mean, it should. No, I'm going to just say no, but you're right. We lose a lot of those hair ties. They're all over the place. And you're like, oh, here's my hair tie.
You are correct. The answer is no on that one. And finally, look at us killing time till Jamie Roberts can log in. Huh? Phone GPS Appreciation Day. Phone GPS Appreciation Day. Do you appreciate the woman or that English man in your phone? Is there an appreciation day?
I am a Wazer. I'm a Wazer, and I do appreciate it.
And you're saying yes or no, it is a real day.
I'm saying no, it's not real.
Man, you're 5 for 5 on that, Suki. Look at you. Good. Look at you. You got them all right. Listen, that's all. That's all I had to stall
Do you
with.
Have and any Jamie's still not on here. J-Lo oh, here he and is. Rod and Ben Affleck.
I can't tell you that J-Lo and Ben Affleck are hot and heavy right now, Suki. I told you she didn't even clean
Miami.
The sheet before she hooked up with him. Listen, Jamie Roberts is in the house.
Amazing.
He figured it out. He got to it. He looks handsome. He's in the green room. I'm going to show you Jamie Roberts. We're going to bring him in on the other side. Very funny guy. Take a look.
You sound like Brian Taft.
What do you mean?
Your voice.
Me, Brian Taft?
Yeah. You can't hear
it? I like Brian Taft.
Yeah. I like Brian Taft too.
The voice you know for news.
Hey, doesn't he sound like Brian Taft?
Brian Taft? I like Brian Taft.
Yeah, I like Brian Taft too.
You want to beat them on the line? I'm killing niggas from state to state everywhere I go. Yo. Remember the chick I was telling you about, my ex? Amanda? Yo, what's up, man? How you doing? How's Cali? What's up? Yay, yay.
They ain't gonna want this. They ain't gonna want that. But it's on me. But don't make it any worse getting face tats. If you messed around and plan.
Welcome to Let's Step Outside, the show where we discuss everything that make you want to tell somebody, let's step outside.
So I'm about to give you the business.
I'm your host, Jamie Roberts.
And I'm Rudolph Valentino.
I'm Rudolph Valentino. That's great. Jamie!
Jamie!
Yes! I finally figured it out. How you guys doing? How
was you finally got in. Listen, we got 3 minutes left in your interview, so I'm glad you made it, bro. Oh,
no, he's kidding you. We got forever for you. Jamie, I can't believe you've been in comedy 20 plus. You got such a baby face. I mean, how is that possible?
Like a baby,
dude. Thank you. I stopped drinking a long time ago. That's
right. Is that why I'm still like, you know, I'm aging? I'm drinking too much.
That is great, man. How you doing, bud? Everything's good. We're glad to have you on. We got a lot to talk about because you got a whole bunch of things going on.
Yeah, I got a couple things in the can. Can't wait to discuss it all. Thank you guys for having me. Thank you to Ray. Thank you to Bouillon for setting it up for me.
Yeah.
Really appreciate them. They're a great team over there.
Good
we
folks
love Bouillon
at Bouillon
TV, the crew TV, the network there. Awesome.
Listen, man, before we get into the comedy part, I was reading a little bit about how you were an accountant, but you gave it up. Was that too exciting for you?
I didn't give it up. They gave up on me. You know?
Oh, they threw you out?
That's how it works when they don't want you anymore. There's nothing funny about taxes. You get what I mean?
Yeah, no, I know, bro. I just went through it. I hate that stuff. But, from being an accountant to going to comedy, that's a nice jump, man. And you actually met your wife. Comedy, right?
Don't bring your work home. I ended up marrying my work. So, that's how it worked. Yeah, that's the beautiful Nikki Sunshine. We've known each other for over 10 years. We dated for 4 years, and we jumped the broom 2019.
Nice.
So how did doing reality TV lead to a stronger relationship with your wife? Like, help me connect the dots. Usually we see it kind of fall apart.
Right.
But for you, Jamie, you were able to turn it around.
After a reality TV show, we were on a show called A Question of Love.
And Jamie, hold that thought right there. Uh-huh. Well, let's check it out. We'll be back on the other
side. Oh, you got clips.
You ready for this?
Here we go.
Yeah, I'm really nervous.
When do you think we'll be ready for marriage?
Good question. I don't know.
I'm going to be responsible for your kids.
Why would I do that? Have I ever asked you for money?
No.
Get it together.
Yeah, you tell her, Jamie. Get it together, baby.
You got to get it together.
We get married. You got to get it together, man. Tell him. How'd you guys?
I got in trouble by all her family for that line.
You know, she gave you the side eye for that. She was like, what?
She's still giving me the side eye, Suki. She's still giving me. Ain't nothing changed.
So listen, man, was that all real emotions or you guys were just kind of playing it up?
No, it was real emotions.
It was, huh?
We had to sit across from one another and ask the tough questions. You know, those questions that you ask one another when you're dating, when you're courting someone, you really don't ask them,
you know, what's your credit score? You know, you ask them nonsense questions like, what's your 5-year plan? You know, oh, where do you see yourself in 3 years from? No one cares about that. You know, hopefully I'll still be sitting across from you 3 years from now.
Right.
And you still return my phone calls. You know, that's what I'm talking about. But we have to ask each other the tough questions on camera to capture the real emotions. And some of those questions, man, you know, they were tough. They were tough. And we figured if we made it through that, we can make it through anything. You know, they involved family. They involved, you know, her father, my mom, my kids. It was, oh, man, it was a lot. It was a lot.
I actually think, like, that's like a good thing that more couples should go through to figure out if they really have what it takes to be together. Because Scott and I were talking half the time. His wife, my husband, I'm like, oh, you'll never believe what the heck happened to me today. You're like another therapy session.
Right. It was like premarital counseling, you know, before we actually had got married.
I love it.
We figured if we survived that, you know, we can do this. And then the pandemic hit. And then
Wait, before you get to that, you guys, you know, as far as social distancing, you didn't do any of that during the pandemic because you got a little gift on the other side, no?
Yeah, we had a pandemic baby, if you want to
know. Yay! Nice.
Little JJ, Jeremiah Jackson Roberts. Yeah,
nice. Remember how happy you guys were right here?
Right.
Yeah. picture that now with no sleep.
Every time someone mentions my son, my knees start hurting because I'm old. You know, just thinking like 3 or 4 years from now, chasing him around the house. Well, you get him. You get him. I forget it. He's going to learn how to cook on his own.
That's it, man. That's it. No, that's good, man. Good for you. Congratulations. Listen, enjoy every minute of it. I know it seems like it'll never end, but it goes real fast.
Yeah.
I'm sure everybody tells you that it goes really fast. You got, I was interested because you started a radio station, right? This 108
yes.
Soul?
Yes,
is that,
108
is that,
Soul.
Is that digital or is that like broadcast?
It's digital. I came from broadcast radio. Sugi, I actually met you on the 17th floor before. Over at Cumulus, yeah. I think you came up there to visit Bernie and Sid one time.
Oh, yeah.
So funny.
I used to be on the Bernie and Sid show. I had a segment called Ask the Black Guy because I was the only black guy.
That is so appropriate for Bernie and Sid.
Ask the Black Guy.
Ask the Black Guy. But I go for broadcast radio. I come from sales. So from comedy, I went into sales. And I started doing sales for Radio 103.9.
Okay.
And 2014 is when I started that journey. And 2014 was actually the first year I headlined at Caroline's. And I met D.L. Hughley in June. And then in September, I started working for D.L. Hughley. Oh, you got all the pictures. Look at you. You're on point, man. Wow, you're good. Who's doing it?
That's me, bro. That's me. I got you covered. I got everything. Everything you're about to say, I got you covered, man.
All right.
Just listen.
The wife, then. That's what
mention George Wallace, would you?
Yeah, George Wallace, man. He came down. He did his. Oh man. Oh, how about this? So the Powerball numbers are. I need those numbers. Can you get those numbers up there?
Wait, hold on. No, wrong one.
I need the Mega Millions and the Powerball. You're good, man.
That's great, man. So
came down. He did a guest spot on my show, man. It was amazing to work with him.
Yeah. Oh my God, you're talking about legends right here.
Legend.
Yeah, legend, man. Mr. Vegas himself. You know, and of course, you know the older comedians. I hate to say old comedian. Oh, my man, Dick Gregory, man. It was a pleasure meeting
Gregory's,
him as well.
Dick was on Dick show. Gregory a couple of times. Yeah.
He was on the show, Dick Gregory.
Yeah. Man. He's a great light. You know, so I'm sad to see that, you know, we lost him a couple of years back. And he gave me some great advice. The same thing that Paul Mooney gave me. He said, you know, you guys, your younger generation, you need to put your phones down and pick up a book. You know, put your phones down and pick up a book. And,
and basically,
he was just saying, you know, you need more knowledge. Gain more knowledge. Just stop. Yeah. Do not stop learning.
Yeah.
You know, that's very important.
Yeah, you know what? Dick Gregory was on our morning show on picks, not on here. That's right.
Oh, no, way. No, he wasn't here last year. If that's the case.
No. Yeah, no. He wasn't on. He wasn't on.
He was on the morning show. He was on picks. Yeah.
I jumped it.
I'm in great time.
He came back to life, Jamie, to give us some, you know, guys.
By the way, Jamie, he came on. He got on easier than you did, by the way.
That's why you got to tell everybody, turn off all the Wi-Fi in the house. Yeah,
he made it. He got in the first time, bud. Listen, you do this thing. I saw something online a little bit. You were doing some man on the street stuff. Take a look at this, Sook. I just want to show you what he was doing on the street.
Comedian Jamie Rouse, you're on the street here with Officer Garcia asking everybody about the Marvel Universe. Who's your favorite Marvel Universe character?
That would be Wolverine, sir.
Wolverine? Yeah. Wolverine with the knives?
With the knives. Because I like knives because I'm Puerto Rican.
He's Puerto Rican. He's a Puerto Rican cop. He's going to trade in the knives for a gun. If you had any superpower, what would it be?
To be immortal.
Immortal. Really? What else? That's it?
Immortal and super strength.
This is immortal. I would
like the Incredible Hulk.
Dope, man. I would want the ability to dead cell phone batteries on the train. So we don't gotta listen to the loud ass. You know what I'm talking about? How people be playing the speakerphone music? That's what I appreciate, man. Thank you for protecting us. We appreciate you, brother.
Thank you.
That's all it took. Comedian Jay Rouse on the street asking people about Marvel Universe. Who is your favorite Marvel character?
Storm.
Get away! We found him! We found him!
Can you tell?
No, not at all, sweetheart.
I'm
not at all.
So inspired by her.
I love that.
That's a good laugh, man. It's a good laugh you got.
Was that part of Sunday Night Live, Jamie?
Excuse me?
Was that part of Sunday Night Live or?
No, it was just something that we just did. Sunday Night Live was that was a great run. We did Sunday Night Live was a show that I hosted and produced for over 10 years, a weekly show here in New York City, and we've had everyone you could think on there. It was a great run. Of course, all good things come to an end. This was pre-pandemic, but it was, you know, I met a lot of connections, got a lot of road work, you know, a lot of comedians who travel the company and stop in New York would hit up my phone. Hey, I'm in New York. Can I get a spot? Who are you again? Jerry Seinfeld. Yeah, come on, you know?
Yeah, you worked with Seinfeld a little bit, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. I was at West Side Comedy Club, and he did a drop-in. I was hosting the club with Bill Burr that night.
Another great comedian. Love Bill.
And so Bill brings it. Yeah. So Bill brings a friend with him. So we're like, yeah, sure, no problem. You know, who's this friend? And in comes Jerry Seinfeld. I'm like, oh, no. I don't think we have any time for him tonight. What do you mean? Can we get one?
Yeah, Jamie, you just got bumped.
Right.
I love it, man.
I love it. Man. You know, comedy brings, especially in this pandemic, really
it's great.
Comedy,
it's you know? So good. It's so good. And you know what? Eugenia Kuzmin is coming up in just a few minutes. She even does stand-up comedy.
Really?
You know, she's a movie star, supermodel. She's doing comedy. Wow. I mean, it's so much fun. We've had a chance to do some stand up, and it's just when you get those laughs coming back at you, it really just, I mean, it pumps you up, man. It's like a drug.
Yes, it is. It's a drug that nobody wants to lose, you know?
Yeah, no, absolutely. And what's been the craziest thing about a newborn, a couple months old for you?
Besides the no sleep thing, is playing rock, paper, scissors, who's going to change him? So,
yeah. And don't listen. And, don't let your wife cheat in the middle of the night because you have your eyes closed, dude. You can't even see what's going on.
She's got me beat because she does the breastfeeding. So you know,
that was me. I was like, at some point, you need to get up. At some point, you're gonna get up.
We need to be the support, right? We're there just the support. What do you
a little support, man? That's
up?
It.
Okay, I'll prop the pillow.
You know, it's hard because the first year is gonna be all on her, Jamie, because she is, you know, choosing to breastfeed. So it's a tough thing. But listen, can I ask you a question? What you know, we're all coming out of the pandemic. New York is slowly opening. Like, what do you do? Are the clubs back? Like, what's happening on the comedy circuit scene?
The clubs are definitely coming back. They opened back up, I think it was May 1st. I'm in no rush to go back into the clubs until we really figure this thing out. But yeah, the clubs are back. We're doing more of a Caroline, they're doing more of a stadium theater type seating just to make sure we keep the social distancing. So we have a show coming up July 24th at Magic Johnson Theater in Harlem. And, nice. You know, it seats 300, but we're only doing 100 tickets. You know, nice. That way we can space them out. And, you know, it's always a great show once we're in Harlem. Harlem, baby. Harlem, USA.
You think you got two extra tickets for a white Jewish guy and an Indian chick from Westchester? Can you fit us in?
I have no idea who you're talking about. I have no idea.
Jamie, you know it's so funny because it's funny you were talking about social distancing still because, quite frankly, you know, I went into a place today and I don't know how you saw this, Scott, but like people are unmasked now and then you're like,
oh yeah, it's wild. I mean, my gym is unmasked now. It's all
you
unmasked
know, the
now.
The thing about it in New York, if you walked around 2 years ago with a mask on, everyone would run for you. If you don't have a mask
right,
on now,
right.
Everybody's going to run.
They look at you like you're nuts. Jamie, listen, right. Man, where could people listen to 108 Soul, my man? Where can they find it?
Oh, they could download the app. It's on TuneIn. Should be on iHeartRadio within the next 2 weeks. And you can listen right through the website, 108soul.com.
Beautiful, bud. Beautiful. And listen, when you're back on stage and you got gigs, come back on, man. We'll promote the heck out of it for you.
Thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate you. You guys are doing a great thing here. Thank you so
listen,
much.
When your wife tells you to go feed the kid at 2 o'clock in the morning, just remember that picture, my friend. Just remember how happy you are at this particular time right there.
I got you. Thank you,
man. I swear to God.
Jamie, thank you, my friend. It was great having you. Listen, keep doing what you're doing. And like I said, come back on when things open up. We'll promote all your gigs.
Appreciate you guys. Keep doing what you're doing. Thank you.
Take care, bud. What a funny guy, Sook. Really good guy.
We were killing him. We're like, yeah, he probably got on easier than you.
Did we ruin childbirth for him at this particular moment?
Nah,
did we ruin
It's hard. You remember when you were being a new parent. It's hard. Jamie is lovely, and it's so nice to see him on the show. And, you know, wishing him the best. I mean, I think that, you know, it's all going to start happening for everybody slowly.
Yeah. Being an old parent isn't so great either. I could tell you that. It's not easy. All right, Sook, listen, we keep rolling along. We got a jam-packed show. Eugenia Kuzmina is coming up next. She's in the new movie, The Elevator, with our guy, Eric Roberts. What a great dude. He was on with us last week. He had such a good time. And boy, he's busier than anybody. He's in a new movie every week, Eric Roberts. Right? he's in like five movies this week. You talk about a great comeback. But Eugenia plays his wife in this movie. She's got an amazing career. Like we said, model, actress, comedy. We'll get into it all with her. Here's a look at the movie trailer, which we didn't have the other night when Eric was on. I played the trailer for Runaway Train from 30 years ago. But here's the movie, the Elevator. We'll bring Eugenia in on the other side. Take a look.
Oh, I really wish I didn't have to go to work today.
Please just stay home today. It's Saturday. Why'd you have to go to work?
Last minute client needs to be done today.
Dad, you'll be home by 3, right?
Yes, I promise.
Would you pick up Peyton's birthday cake after track? I'd appreciate it.
Well, I can't today. At the track, I have a math tutor.
What, you're not doing well in math?
Good morning, Gary.
What are you doing here on Saturday?
Work, work, work. Gotta do it.
Morning, Roman.
You're in a better agreement for the Brooklyn ad campaign.
They're signing it.
My specialty is to convince. I just can't convince my family how important this work is.
Daddy's working so we can have this house.
But Daddy doesn't even know my favorite color. Does Daddy know your favorite color, Mommy?
Of course he does. Do you need anything else?
It's Peyton's birthday. Then I have to take her gift.
You'll be the only one in the building.
The only one in the building. Hold on a second, this is my kid.
Dad.
I got a surprise for you when I get home.
Dad?
I can't find your father.
What do you mean you can't find him?
Don't roam on me.
I'm looking for my father's vehicle?
I'm sorry, I can't give out that information.
My dad's missing.
911.
My husband is supposed to be home hours ago. My husband is missing. It was an accident. I have a strong reason to believe he's admitted to this hospital.
By the time you find this letter, I'm not sure if I'll still be here.
Life is about family.
this movie.
Oh, Sook, I'm getting claustrophobic just looking at it. There she is.
We're getting claustrophobic.
You know, a funny story. While we were shooting that, actually, Eric and Murkesh, the producer, and I think our director got stuck in the elevator.
They really got stuck in an elevator?
Yeah, I think we jinxed them.
Oh my God. Yeah, Eric said he got a little claustrophobic, but at least shooting, it wasn't really a closed elevator, right?
No. You know, I got so close with everybody on set and just watching it back, you know, Matt Rife, who is playing my son, is amazing, who's also a comedian. And we would go after this shoot and do comedy all over New York, which was so fantastic.
Oh, that's great. And the young girl is Avery?
Yeah, there's two Averys, Avery Morris and Avery Ilardi. And they were both amazing and, you know, just fantastic kid actors. I think it's so hard. And my daughter wrote a song for a film. So we really bonded. It was
God, that's great. I think one of them, Eugenia, you put the graphic up on Instagram that you were coming on tonight. And I think one of the Averys said that she was a huge fan of Sookie's from when she was on Fox 5 here in New York. She said she used to watch Sook all the time. She's like, oh my God, I love Sookie.
How cute. Have those kids on the show. They're just fantastic and brilliant actors. I think they can teach, you know, everybody.
Eugenia, your career is like, it should be a story in itself. I mean, just like, you know, how you were born, your father, this like complete intellectual.
Yeah. Not very smart. Not very smart parents, I see.
Yeah, just nuclear scientists.
You know? Nuclear scientists. So.
Just a nuclear scientist. I mean, you know, like it's complete intellectual. You're ice skating. Someone sees you. And then boom, you're off on this adventure.
I know. I'm still on it. You know, it's like a roller coaster.
Yeah, boom. Next thing you know, here she is on the cover of magazines. But it really is wild. When did you guys come over from Russia and you just, you know, obviously you were doing things there, but what made you come over this way?
Well, you know, in like end of 90s, beginning 2000s, a lot of times they would export and ship girls from like Russia and Brazil, you know, and Giselle started a little bit before me. And, you know, they needed diversity in modeling world. And a lot of us took that opportunity, you know, just we were coming not for glamour, you know, anything else like show business. Mm-hmm. We were just coming because we needed to make money for our families. Of course, it changed now. But, you know, at that time, that was my biggest motivation, like to move at 15 and support my family.
Yeah. A Ford model signed you. I mean, that's like, that's huge.
Yeah, no, it's wild.
I can't imagine your father being who he is saying, okay, honey. You know, being that total intellectual, I want you to go, you know, kind of explore this. What did he say about all of it when you were kind of starting?
Yeah, my dad was furious. Actually, at 13, I think 14, I went to Paris with my mom and they signed out contracts, they paid for our tickets and it was like a ticket out. But my dad wouldn't send a letter letting me go. So we really had to beg him. And it was fine. He thought like I would finish dancing on the tables, they will take my passports away, like, you know, that's it. Like, my dad was convinced. But yeah, I mean, I came, I made my own money. I think I made like $5,000 in a month, which was huge for us, for Russia, you know?
Yves Saint-Laurent, Alexander McQueen, Terry Mugler, Hermes, Armani, Dior, L'Oreal. I mean, like, you have done it all.
Yeah, I've done it all. And then at 15, I lost my dad. So I actually had to make a conscious decision to go and support my mom and my sister and, you know, be homeschooled. And I finished school after all my shoots instead of going to parties and things like that. I would be home.
By the way, Sookie, I've walked into every one of those stores. So let's give me a little credit, okay? Eugenia, when it comes
very fast, I mean, that's hard at 15, having to have to grow up that fast.
Yeah, for sure. You know, for anybody, like growing up in a different culture, country, and learning about money and like how to manage it was interesting.
It's great. Listen, you know, as I said, we had Eric Roberts on last week. Such a fantastic guy. He's so busy. What was that like working with him in the elevator? You know, a legendary movie star who started out here. He had his personal problems, came back. He's now one of the busiest guys in Hollywood. You know, what was that like for you working with an actor like him?
Well, you know, movies, what I love about movies, it's definitely teamwork. And I feel anybody who who had more experience is elevating you, you know, to your better game. So of course, you know, having him there and having experience doing so many films in so many countries and so many sets, I just love watching him and his process and, you know, how he works and his character and what he brings. And he's just a natural talent.
Yeah.
And you know, getting to know him after that, we did another film together in pandemic. So, you know, and yeah, just him and his wife, lovely people in and out, you know, and of course I'm just there to learn, you know.
Yeah. And that movie's coming out, I believe this summer, he said. It's coming out in theaters and on digital. And another fellow who we had on last week was also a good friend of ours, John DiDomenico.
Oh my God.
John, who plays, he's the best Trump in America. And you were his Melania in a show, right? Or a couple sketches you guys were doing.
We actually are going to Vegas. We have a huge show in Vegas with Jeremy Piven and John as
well. Yes.
So yeah, it's coming. We're going on Fox News, I believe, next week to kind of do, you know, he's going to do Trump and they're going to play a little clip of us playing together. So yeah, it comes full circle.
John's the best. He is really the best. And we were talking about, you know, you and your comedy. Let's watch this real quick and let's see if Suki laughs at this one. You ready? Because I thought it was pretty funny. And the guy laughing in the audience just cracks me up too. So here, did you plant this guy? Let me play it and you let me know.
Okay. I almost married this producer. He's half Polish, half Italian. He made me an offer I couldn't understand.
That guy laughing cracks me up just the way he's laughing.
Oh my God. It's so funny because, I was doing a film with Bill Murray at the time, and I think one of the actors had this book, which is called like really bad, like the worst jokes ever. And I decided to write all these jokes, you know, that are really the terrible, terrible jokes and kind of try it out. So that was a total experimental show, which
it's so funny. I was watching some of your stand up all day and it was pretty funny because you had that one guy cracking up the whole time. He was hysterical.
Yeah.
I'm like, she must have planted that guy in the audience, for goodness sake.
I don't know. Maybe he was on some. I don't know. You guys.
When somebody laughs like that, do you find it distracting or do you just go with it? Because I have an awful laugh that like is like when it comes out, it comes out. But like when it's funny, it's really funny. So I feel like he was enjoying every moment of that.
It's so great. You know, I was watching the comedian who was before me, Jamie, and he seems like have such a genuine laugh. I was literally, I think, you know, I'm there at the end of the day. I'm not there just for cheap laughs. You know, I'm there to educate people. I think I do comedy for a very specific reason. And it's not just like, oh, I get off on laughs, you know, I'm there to communicate and bring some awareness. And like, it's cool if people laugh, but sometimes I can have very dark sense of humor and people can be shocked as well.
And you have a lot of self-deprecating jokes where you just make fun of yourself, like, oh, I forgot I'm a model, or, you know, you just kind of goof on yourself, you know, for being a model. But it's so great. Now you obviously you started out doing a lot of modeling first, right? Before you became an actress, what was your introduction to acting? Like, what was the first thing you did that was actually filmed?
Well, I did a few music videos, which were amazing, you know, in Paris. And one of the musicians, David Halliday, I think that was one of my first music videos. And then I moved to US, and actually my first film, I went to audition after I had my kid. Yeah, I just had my kid. And I was in such rage and, you know, this crazy mood of being a parent. So I walk in the audition and they're like, well, show us some darkness that you have. And I was like, no problem. And I was hired on the spot. It was for Rodrigo Prieto, the cinematographer of Babel and, you know, Wolf of Wall Street. And he was doing his first film with Elle Fanning and a few other actors. And it was fantastic. It just was a natural transition. You know, because I was in LA and my husband was a producer. So I landed in the middle of show business, not knowing that, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. And listen, you know, your husband, Bill Block, he's like the head of Miramax now, right?
You know, out of all the jokes.
That's unbelievable.
I know. Life is funnier than comedy. Like, you can't invent things sometimes.
Yeah, my God. That's amazing. But listen, you know, so many movies that we've seen, like I remember seeing you in Bad Moms, and yeah. you were great in that movie. And you know, you look at the cast of that movie and you got to look around and be like, wow, look at the people I'm in this movie with.
Yeah.
Right. And you're just like, holy cow, where am I right now?
I was so proud of that movie, you know, because everybody was a mom there, like for real. And I think some of them brought babies. I think Mila just had a baby. So there were like no fighting on sets, no fighting over trailers. You know, everybody was so humble and like, it was a real creative process. And plus the directors, they did The Hangover, as you guys know. So they were just a blast to work with. And it was a perfect time.
I love it. And, but you know what? You make it look so easy in the sense that like, you know, I mean, I got to imagine going up to be a stand-up comedian. I don't know what's harder. Is it stand-up comedy or acting? Because I think both of them are like incredibly difficult. I can't imagine.
You know, the hardest thing for me is I think singing. And this year I went on a show. It's called I Can See Your Voice on Fox.
Yes. And, yes. Yeah,
Ken John was hosting it and there was Ken Rhymes and I had to pretend to be a good singer, right? And I auditioned and I got it as a bad singer.
Really? And, what song did you use for the audition?
Well, I think I used Celine Dion. I went all the way. You know, it was like hard to it out. Yeah.
Eugenia, this is a singing heavy show. So if you can give us like the first 15 seconds of that, let us see we'll tell you if it was bad or good. Go ahead.
You have to watch the show. You have to watch the show. I actually can't say more. So maybe I was a good singer. Maybe I was a bad singer. I don't know. You have to watch the show.
Is there a song that you sing that you think you sing well?
Well, yeah, there was a song. It's called Call Me by Blondie. So
Call me on the line.
Yeah. That's it.
You were pretty good, Eugenia. I'm sorry. I think you're very good.
So what movie is that from? Do you remember?
Blondie. That's Sonnyman. Which movie?
American Psycho.
No, it was from with Richard Gere plays a male prostitute.
Oh, yes. Oh,
yeah. Gigolo.
American Gigolo.
Yeah. I remember that. It was recent.
Call me.
Back when Christian Bale was banging a few chicks on American Psycho.
It might have been. You never know. Eugenia, what do you have? You have a lot of things cooking after this movie. You have other things on the fire. I mean, listen, your husband's the head of Miramax. I know there's another movie that you're going to be in sooner or later.
Oh, you know, it's been so busy actually in pandemic as well. So in January, we shot a new film with Guy Ritchie and Jason Statham.
Wow.
That was so exciting. I mean, it was, you know, a little bit intense, especially after 2020, just to get back on set with like hundreds of extras and, you know, everybody involved. So that's very exciting. I have Spicy, the TV show with Dominic Cooper, which is on AMC now. It was really fun to work on that as well. I'm currently doing a film with Bruce Willis, which is an action film, training, doing my own stunts.
Wow.
Yeah. It's been pretty intense.
You're really busy for like...
Yeah, she's busy. Yeah.
Yeah. I did a film last night. We were shooting at Chateau Marmont, and it's so funny, just got it by accident because my friend was there a week ago and she fell on the stairs and she stood up and there was a director who said, well, you know, I need this like two characters for a film, and it turned out to be amazing film.
Oh, that's so funny.
Yeah, very good actress.
Eugenia, could you just let your husband know if he ever needs a couple of extras for a movie, we could, Suki and I could stand in the background. We're always ready to go. We'll fly out to LA. I have no talent
whatsoever when it comes to acting, Eugenia. Yeah. Nor do I have talent when it comes to comedy.
No, don't say that. You never know. Never say never.
Listen, the movie that's coming out, The Elevator, with our guy Eric Roberts from D-Star Entertainment. Eugenia, what can we expect when we sit down to watch this movie? It looks like it's gonna make you sweat a little bit watching him in that elevator, by the way.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's a family film, you know, it's a really kind of sweet thing to remind you that your family matters and time matters. And, you know, can definitely relate to that, like running around, not, you know, balancing career and work. So I think it's a really sweet movie to remind that what is really important.
I think so too.
That's amazing. That's
especially
amazing.
Now, and we need that kind of understanding. And I think we were all taught that lesson during the pandemic that really family is everything.
For sure. Time priorities differently changed for me.
And before you go, just tell me what's happening here. Who's this gun pointed at?
Oh my God. You know, I'm so much better now. I'm training with Taryn Tactical, who works with John Wick. You know, who works with Keanu and all these films. But I think at that time, they just put me on set. They gave me a gun and said, like, okay, you're playing an FBI agent with Sandy Kadick at, you know, it's called Castle, the TV series. And yeah, I'm not really proud of my gun work, to be honest. I was like, professional, but it got much better. It was really fun. We were shooting in downtown LA, and I think people thought it was like real shooting going on, so you know,
unreal.
Pretty wild.
New York these days, Eugenia, you just don't know.
I know. Yeah, we're planning to come to New York, you know, to do a few stand-up shows. So I can't wait to check out the scene there.
Listen, you got to let us know when you're coming in, because I could heckle you from the audience.
Please, oh my God, I love heckling. Fun.
Eugenia, do you get to kiss Jason Statham or Bruce Willis or anything like that? Are there any?
No. We're more like a spy type of, you know, territory. So yeah, we're cool.
So funny. Eugenia, listen, thank you so much for coming on. The movie is called The Elevator. Eugenia Kuzmina, Eric Roberts, and it looks fantastic. I know Eric said it comes out in the summertime.
I think so.
Right. It's coming out in the summer, and we'll promote it more. We'll give out the dates once it becomes official. But thank you so much. You're an absolute pleasure. Keep doing that stand-up comedy, and you know, just keep doing everything you're doing, because you got it all going on, young lady.
Thank you, guys. And see you on the set of next film. Right?
Yes. And listen.
Yes. Okay.
Eugenia.
Call him.
Thank you. Take care.
You guys. Take
Bye-bye.
Care.
Bye.
Oh, my God. She's beautiful. She's a mom. I mean, she's like everything.
Yeah. Wow, Sook. She's
just everything.
She's busy.
Can you hear
busy,
me? Am busy. I having problems?
Well, you sound a little muffled today. You know what I mean?
I told you I dropped my mic. I don't know if that has anything to do with it. Is that
there
better?
There you go. Just stick it right under your chin and see if that works.
All right. Maybe that's better.
Yeah, there you go. That is better.
All right, better. Okay.
Listen, Sook, we are far from done. I mean, Jamie Roberts, Eugenia Kuzmina, and we were talking about how this is, you know, we're at Memorial Day weekend right now, and we have got an amazing group to tell you about. New Directions Veterans Choir. You know, you watch these guys. They were on America's Got Talent several years ago, and they were formerly homeless vets, Sook. U.S. military, formerly homeless. They started this group, and now they're just, you know, it really helps, you know, veterans from, you know, Army, Air Force, you know, Navy, the Marines, and basically it gives them a purpose. It gives them some direction. And not to mention that they're extremely talented. So take a look. Here's New Directions, and we'll bring a couple in on the other side. Here you go.
How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Dum-ba-dum-ba-dum.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Dum-ba-dum-ba-dum.
Do-ba-dum.
I needed the shelter of someone's arms. Than you were. I needed someone to understand my ups and downs. There you were. With sweet love and devotion. Deeply touching my emotion. I want to stop and thank you, baby. I just want to stop and thank you, baby. Oh, yeah.
We are New Directions Veterans Choir. And we're coming in your direction.
How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Ah, how sweet it is to be in love by you. So listen, you got George Hill, who founded this whole thing, Michelle Main, and just two of the members of this amazing group. They keep adding on. Guys, welcome to the show. An honor to have you. And I've been watching videos all day, and man, I'm just singing along with you. That's all I can say.
Great. Well, thank you very much. I hadn't seen that video in quite some time, yeah, but I was smiling watching it because I forgot. Yeah, no,
it's so good. It's so great, good in every way. George, I mean, you're the choir founder. Tell everybody about how you started it. You went from being homeless for 12 years, and then you just created this phenomena that's not only reaching out to so many people, but also bringing to light what it is to be a soldier in America and the hardships and battles that people do face.
Well, one of the things, especially in my particular case, I spent 12 years coming straight, living on the streets, and I had no idea that I was suffering from PTSD. That's the main thing. Wow. And it wasn't until I finally came in, and it's really strange because on Skid Row, out of all the people that were down there, I seen a guy who had rags tied on his feet. I would have never had even when you're out there, you don't see that. And of all the people on Skid Row, he walked up to me and he looked down at me and snarled and reached his hand in his pocket and put out a dollar and change. And he shoved it at me and said, "Here, man, I feel sorry for you." And I'm like, what? You know, because I'm kind of pissed. You know, you feel sorry for me, you know, but because I'm thinking I feel sorry for you. You know, but I started thinking about it. It's like, man, what is there about me that this man feels sorry for? And and something about that just didn't sit well with me. And back at the time, the VA didn't have the greatest of reputations, but I knew that, you know, I'm a veteran, I'm gonna go. And when I got there, through the treatment that they afforded me and through New Directions, because that's who we sing for. New direction set back, and I was able to learn that I was, and I didn't know it until all that time, that I was suffering from PTSD. And I knew if I was, that there was other veterans that were. And that's that's what we did today. We were going out in a riverbed looking for homeless veterans. And it's just, it's just been fortunate. So what happened was, I used to sing in the tunnels at MacArthur Park, the one that's in the song. And that was my
studio. That Donna Summer sang about?
Yes, that MacArthur Park. It's a really huge, beautiful park. And I would sing in the tunnel for hours because being homeless is a miserable experience. Yeah. And that kept me sane while I was out there. And because of that, when I came and finally got into treatment in the New Directions, it sounded like my studio. So I started singing. And at this particular time, a lot of vets were dying. You know, suicide was really high. People were dying from the exposure to the elements. And the senators came, and the founder of the program wanted them to know, not only do we get our lives back, but we have fun too. And they said, "You're always singing, put together a choir." So I put together a choir, and we did Lean On Me, because that's what we felt like. And it just kept going from there, and it just kept going on and on. And then I finally met my friend. This is Michelle. She's actually the only normie in the group. That's what we call them. See, the rest of us, we call her the resident normie. She's an RN that, you know, that she helps the veterans. And then she actually is a choir, as a choir director herself. And she called herself Gonna Help, but she got with us and she just loved what we did so much that, well, I guess I'll let her explain.
No, Hi, Michelle. Hello. I thought I was just going to be helping, like giving them some chords or playing if they sang in church. And then every time I went, they were like, "Okay, this person's missing. You take that part." And so it just worked out so well. They're the nice people that you could ever work with.
You never know. Listen, we're going to talk more, but can you guys give us a little something together? I know the group isn't there, but can you give us a little something together for like a minute?
Well,
It's kind of hard to sing with missing voices, but maybe what we'll do, since it's Memorial Day, there is a song that we close every single performance for. because we sing to help veterans. That's mainly who's there, and that's what we did and why. But okay. We sing for the veterans that didn't make it back. And it was a song that came back from the time when our nation was even more split than it was now during the Civil War. So okay. we don't care about the political correctness. We just go ahead and sing it. So you want to start it off?
We're starting in the middle.
Go ahead.
In the beauty of the lilies, Christ was born across the sea. With a glory in his bosom that transfigures you and me.
As he died to make men holy, let us die to make men free. While God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Our God is marching. Anyway. On. But we sing all of, oh, thank you. Because nice. It's really important.
Yeah, thank you.
We don't fail to mention the veterans that never make it back. And we do that at every show, no matter where we are in the country. And it doesn't matter that it's Memorial Day or Veterans Day, we pay homage to them because even with all the problems of the country, this country allows us all freedoms that we wouldn't have other places. And I've been other places and, you know,
your message is brought across so beautifully through music, right? Music is something that brings everybody together.
Right.
So
right.
Through doo-wop, through, you know, R&B, soul. Yeah. You're able to honor your message, which is on this Memorial Day, more important than ever, that we realize that all of the freedoms that we have in this country, we should never take for granted, because there are so many people that did not make it back, and families that are suffering every day, missing a loved one, thinking about a loved one, and, you know, the ultimate sacrifice. So, I mean, it's amazing, George, that you were able to turn your life around. And then not only did you give your life to, you know, to our country by serving, but then you were able to turn your life around and now help others. I mean, it's just, I applaud you on this Memorial Day.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, thank you. I really appreciate that. But believe it or not, when I was getting my life back, you know, I couldn't believe it. And that's what we call it, getting our lives back. And one of the things that I found out, and those of us who have veterans in our families, you can tell they're usually not the same when they return. Some people come back and they're totally fine. Others don't. And it comes down to the stress, because usually you don't think about it. But when you prepare to die, it changes you in ways that you can't predict. And different people handle it in different ways. And what in my case, and one of the things that I try to do is remove the stigma, because I'm supposed to be this American fighting man, yet almost dying didn't sit well with me. It set me off. And then you try not to let it get to you, because number one, you will not rise in the ranks if this thing happens to you. If you all of a sudden now dying has messed with you, how are you going to get to that next level? So you stuff it. And what happens is I think one of the greatest things is allow veterans to talk about it and know that they're not by themselves. And that's what I've been blessed enough to do. And it doesn't make sense to not do that and to not help people. And one of the things that they told me is, don't repay kindness, pass it on. And that's what I've been doing. And then someone said, hey, you can get paid for that. You do it anyway. And then so now I work for the Veterans Affairs. And like, I was all up under the bushes. I was in the train tracks. I was all up under bridges and enjoyed every minute of it.
That's great. I love it. And listen, I want to talk about, you know, you guys hitting it big on AGT, America's Got Talent. But I know not everybody's there. So I want to show our audience and Souk a little more of the new directions Veterans Choir. Watch.
It's the circle of life, and Corrections Veterans Choir, and we're comprised primarily of formerly homeless soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines.
Oh, 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 oh.
Nah,
my name is Carlton Lewis Griffin. I'm a Vietnam veteran of the United States Navy from 1971 through 1975. I spent over 25 years homeless on the streets of Los Angeles, and I came to the VA, specifically to New Directions, and they helped me get my life together.
I'm a registered nurse at the VA hospital in West Los Angeles. We sing a song together, His Eyes on the Sparrow. And when we do that song, it makes us, you can see clearly that it makes us both happy. We've become a family.
We call ourselves family, and we call ourselves family for good reason.
It just feels like one big happy family.
I sing because I'm happy.
Because we do consider ourselves family, we can call on each other at the drop of a hat for anything, about anything, it doesn't really matter.
No, he watches me.
Not bad, guys. I could see you guys out there doing As We Stroll Along Together.
You know what's really funny is, like, when we were on America's Got Talent, it seemed like every time we got up to 500,000 hits, they pulled it, then they put it back, and then we get another 500,000, and they kept doing it. And now there's a four-piece of us doing What's Your Name? That's got millions of hits.
That's right.
It's traveling across Facebook now, getting millions of hits, and it's funny.
That's wild. But go ahead, George. I was going to say, how'd you enjoy the AGT experience, just being on that national stage?
It was actually very good. They did us very well because we were able. Because sometimes, you know, what they do is they'll cut people and you just see snippets of us. They gave us a whole 9 minutes because it's really something. We have our stories. It's real and it's true and we live it. And we actually love what we do when we're on stage. I think that's what it is. We actually started out singing a cappella simply for lack of having the other resources to do that. Mm-hmm. But but what happened was is we found that audiences love a cappella because when it's done right and it's done well, it's unlike anything else.
Right. And yeah,
and after AGT, there was a person that he said, okay, look, so he called in a favor and he called in Morgan Ames, who is like, she's famous. Her first hit, believe it or not, was with Harry Belafonte. I forget which one. But she's the one who wrote the song and for Beretta. That's her first television, but she did Beretta. She did Moonlighting, and she's done scores throughout there. And the reason why we sing the Circle of Life, that's the Disney song, is because she has something to do there. That was arranged for us by the person who actually Carmen Twilley, that sings it in the movie. So they managed to get with us and help us. Turned us from a bunch of amateurs to traveling professionals, even though we don't consider that, but I guess we are.
Listen, I've got a little treat for you guys. The third member of our show is a gentleman by the name of Phil Paz. And Phil, we met Phil last year. He was one of the first guests on our show. He went viral. He's a veteran, military guy, SWAT, police, Oklahoma City, the whole deal in Oklahoma. And Phil, he went viral by singing in his squad car, and now he's got millions of followers on his page. Phil was one of our first guests. We love Phil so much. He's become such a good friend of ours. He's on the show every night. We call it like the overtime. He's got 12 million viral viewers over on his page. So I wanted to bring Phil in because I know he wanted to say hello to you guys. Yes, hey, Philly kid.
Hey, how you doing, Michelle and George?
But not only that, I know Philly kid. I like to call him Philly kid. He is older than me. I will admit that. he had a couple. I said, Phil, just be prepared with a couple of your top military songs tonight. So I know he wanted to, give you guys a little surprise with a tune, and then we'll talk a little more.
So how you guys doing, Michelle and George?
Right. How are you?
Good, man. Hey, listen, I got to tell you, I'm a veteran myself, 24 years in the Air Force. I've worked with veterans for years, helping them get their benefits, their VA benefits. My last year and a half on the police department, I was on the homeless outreach team. And, Oklahoma City. Yeah, Oklahoma City, they formed that team on the police department because, we thought, hey, there's got to be a better way, because we can't just keep giving people tickets or taking them to jail or whatever. We need, as officers, we need to be able to help people get resources, to basically help them survive the street, get them some medical care, get them some food, some shelter, a roof over there, whatever. And so that's what I did for my last year and a half on the police department. And it was quite the experience. I mean, you lived it, man. You saw the things that went on the street and I saw some things that I'm never going to forget for the rest of my life. Hopefully I was able to help some people, but I was listening to the story and the history of the New Directions Veterans Choir. And I'm getting chills just thinking about the story, listening to your story. And I know so many other people are too. And from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for what you guys do, because you are inspirational is such a cliche, but that's what it is. You guys are such an inspiration to me and many, many others. And also, Mr. Hill, as the founder of the group, your story gave me chills to no end. I'm proud of you guys, Michelle, you as well, for stepping in and helping out, doing what you're doing. And if you would allow me to, I'd like to sing a little tribute to you. It goes a little bit something like this. I know you're a Marine Corps veteran. Thank you for your service.
Yes. Thank you.
From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we fight our country's battles in the air, on land and sea. First to fight for right and freedom, and to keep our honor clean. They are proud to claim the title of United States Marine. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy hood with brotherhood. From sea to shining sea, we all need, oh, we all need somebody to lean on. You guys are an inspiration. I love you for what you do, and thank you so very, very much.
Thank you so very much.
Do you need a ringer for the choir? Can we offer Phil up?
I was already thinking that. What city are you in, Phil?
I live in Oklahoma City.
Excellent.
Yeah, next time you guys are on America's Got Talent, maybe you want to take them with you.
We'll have to do that. And you know, by the way, thank you, because like today we were out with homeless outreach from the Sheriff's Department. And nice. I must admit, I was highly impressed by their professionalism and the way that they went about handling business. It made sure people didn't mind seeing them. They weren't the enemy. That, I mean, and that's important. I found that more refreshing than you think, because when you're homeless, a lot of times you're used to being rousted, and that's not the way that they were received. So really, right. from the bottom of my heart, and I'm not just saying this, I mean it, thank you, because the homeless outreach for the police department is a class all their own, and your touch and professionalism is excellent.
Thank you. Thank you. Right, thank you. I mean, we're all team players, man. And thank you guys too.
Listen, Michelle and George, before you guys go, I got one more video that I found, which I thought was great. I think it was before a marathon in Boston, not the Boston Marathon, but another marathon. Take a look. You guys sound, I just love it. I love the doo-wop sound you guys got going. Take a listen.
All the illegal activities can never will be loaded farther than me. Let me tell you now, when I come home feeling tired, I go up where I get away from the hustling crowd and all that racket down in the street.
Wow,
this is amazing.
Hey, listen, man, you can get your songs on, you guys are have stuff on Amazon too, right? If people want to hear some stuff.
We do actually. Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's amazing, wow. man. That's amazing. Nice. New Directions Veterans Choir, George Hill, Michelle Main, guys, thank you so much. Thank you for everything you do. And listen,
and
one day,
believe it or not, before we go, she's actually the leader of a group.
Yeah.
Called Lifetime Quartet.
Lifeline Quartet.
Hold on. Lifeline. Listen, I think Michelle, before we go, she might have to give us a little solo on something here, because I think she's holding back. I think we're missing out here.
I'm telling you.
Come on, Michelle, you can do it. Do it.
Michelle, how often do the five of us get together here? I think you need to give us a little something solo before we go.
Okay.
Go ahead, you pick it.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child, a long way from home. A long way from home.
Ooh. Ooh.
Nice. Guys, listen, it's a pleasure having you. Thank you so much for your service.
Thank you so much for having us. Thank you for inviting us. And thank you, Phil. Those songs were excellent.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Yeah.
Love you guys.
George, I'm his manager and his agent, so if you need him.
I got to say, Scott, you are excellent. I saw you were plugging your way back there. I was like, woo.
I got 15% of everything he does, so let me know. And we're good. But listen, guys, thank you so much. And one day I'd love to get the whole group on here. But unfortunately, with this technology, it's all got to be in the same room. So when Suki and I have this show in a studio one day, you guys will all come in and we'll have you on all together.
As guests.
All right. Great. Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Thank you so much, guys.
Phil's going to be the musical conductor. So he's going to make sure everything is all set.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Take care.
All right. Bye, Michelle. Bye, George. Happy Memorial Day. Thank you.
Bye, Suki. Thank you.
Wow. New Directions Veterans Choir. I told they're amazing, right, guys?
Yes.
I mean, I could have listened to them sing a lot and just tell their story. I mean, that was just very deep. And George was so honest about, you know, the everything that he dealt with to get on the other side, which
there was one of the guys, Suk, in the videos, because he spoke on AGT. He said how he was a homeless vet for 25 years. And one day he took his shopping cart and he walked like 30 miles to the new Directions facility. And he just turned his life around after 25 years of being homeless. Guy walked 30 miles with his cart and got there and turned it around. He was one of the singers with the deep voice.
Yes, he was talking about that. Yeah.
Yeah. And he was just amazing. But listen, guys, Suk, happy Memorial Day.
Happy Memorial Day. And Phil, I mean, thank you so much for that rendition, everything that you put together, the collaboration. That was just so beautiful. And I think, you know, on this day, on this Memorial Day, I think it's so important for us to really honor so many people that came before us that are still fighting on the front lines, and also to help support everybody. Like you were talking about the transition back home. And, you know, when he was talking about the PTSD, I mean, just really bring awareness to veterans, and all of us need to be really aware of it as well.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Suki. Thank you. Gosh. Yeah.
Suk, we're going to I'll let you go.
All right, guys. Happy Memorial Day.
You Philly too, Suki. Love you.
A few more tunes. Suk, we love you, babe. I'll see you tomorrow. Philly Kid. Nicely done, my friend. I think they were very taken aback with you.
Oh man, I'm taken aback by them. I cannot imagine. You know, I work with veterans, but homeless veterans, but they were homeless veterans.
Yeah.
And it's just so unbelievable. They can, you know, they turn their lives around and were able to work out of it. And it's just amazing.
Yeah. No, it's great, man. It's great. And listen, you know, when Memorial Day comes around each year, you know, so many people just say, oh, hey, it's a Monday off. Hey, we're off on Monday. There's no school.
Right.
But it's, you know, people forget sometimes what the actual, you know, what Veterans Day, Memorial Day, you know, Labor Day, what those holidays are about. But, you know, someone like you who actually lived it, you know, I got to assume, you know, like a Memorial Day is a lot more for you when you know, that Monday comes around every year.
It is. It really is. You know, I do the celebration thing with the family, and, you know, and we do sit around the pool and do what most Americans do. But we also take time to reflect on what it means to me is the sacrifices, the great, great sacrifices made by millions and millions of men and women of our country who sacrificed their lives. They sacrificed, you know, and if they didn't sacrifice their lives, they sacrificed their mental health. They sacrificed their physical health. They sacrificed time away from their families, you know, when their families were home worrying if they were ever going to hear from them again from day to day. Just sacrifice is too small of a word, but, you know, I don't know what else to say. It's just the sacrifice made by, you know, great, great Americans who want to see our way of life and our freedoms continued. And, you know, that's why they do it. And that's why I did it. You know, I'm lucky enough myself to, you know, I'm still here, but, you know, a lot of us, we have survivor's guilt because we, you know, yeah, I'm back home with my wife and my family and my grandchildren, but why do I get to be when my buddies didn't?
Right.
So, you know, that's a sacrifice in and of itself to a lot of guys and girls that come back. And, you know, George talked about the PTSD. That's a big issue, you know. And as you know, that's another one of my big things that I try to bring awareness to is, you know, mental health awareness for veterans and first responders, police officers. And tip a few back because, you know, I will, but also just take a minute to remember, and reflect on the sacrifices that were made by some great, great Americans so you can continue your way of life.
Do you, you got another like commemorative song you want to do?
I may have one or two.
I've seen you do them on Facebook once or twice.
Yeah, this is one that is very popular. A lot of people like this song. I've got probably, I don't know how many, a lot of views. And back in the 60s when it came out, it was kind of looked at as a cheesy song.
Ballad of the Green Beret?
Yes, sir.
Oh, look at me picking that out of the hat.
But it's one of my favorites, and it gives me chills every time I hear it or sing it. So,
go ahead. I love that. Go. Okay.
Fighting soldiers from the sky, fearless men who jump and die, men who mean just what they say. These brave men of the Green Beret, silver wings upon their chest. These are men, America's best. 100 men will test today, but only 3 earn the Green Beret. Trained to live off nature's land, trained in combat hand to hand. Men who fight by night and day, courage take from the Green Berets. Silver wings upon their chest, these are men, America's best. 100 men will test today, but only 3 earn the Green Beret. Back at home, a young wife waits. Her Green Beret has met his fate. He has died for those oppressed, leaving her his last request. Put silver wings on my son's chest. Make him one of America's best. He'll be a man they'll test one day. Have him earn the Green Beret. One of my favorites.
Nice. Nicely done, my friend. Yeah, listen, man, it's crazy. Suki and I were talking about it before the show. It's amazing that it's Memorial Day 2021 already.
Yes.
When we were, you know, just a year ago, it was like, holy cow, is the world coming to an end? What's happening? And it looks like, you know, things are, you know, obviously in some places, no, but for the most part in our country, right? They said that the half of Americans have been vaccinated. And, you know, hopefully by the end of the summer, things are, we're rolling along. But listen, man, it's like I said, Memorial Day, Veterans Day, people, you know, they can't forget why they're off from work.
Right.
It's not just about the barbecues and everything else. But and Philly, you remind me every day, baby, wearing those shirts. And I listen, personally, I thank my lucky stars that I was born after the Vietnam War. You know what I mean? Or too, right. I was born, you know, I was a kid and then, you know, too old to ever be drafted. I think there was one point when I was in college in 85, 86. And I remember they were talking about maybe having you register for the draft again. And
yeah.
I was just, oh my God, just thinking about it. I was like, yeah, no, I can't do it, man. There's no way I could do that.
Yeah.
It's just amazing. It's amazing that you guys, you know, you did it and, you know, you came out on the other side unscathed.
Yeah. And, you know, I always tell, whenever I get the chance to tell this story, Speaking of sacrifice and family, when I was, and speaking of Vietnam, my dad was a Vietnam veteran. And when I was, how old was I? I was six years old when he went to Vietnam. And I was there at home with my mom, my older sister, a younger sister, and a baby brother. And he was in Vietnam for, just under a year, but still. And I can remember, mom would get letters from him and she would sit on the couch and of course she would cry. And when you see your mother crying, you're going to sit there and all the kids would sit there and hug her and cry. And she was scared. She was scared that he wasn't going to make it back. She would never say that to us, but now as an adult, she was afraid that he was not going to come back.
Yeah.
And plus she was just scared of being living day-to-day life without, big strong man around to take care of things if need be. And I can remember every night mom would gather us in her bedroom and she'd say, all right, y'all help me push the bed against the door. And she would push the bed against the door. We would all scoot the bed against the door, it was to protect her children from intruders because she's a small woman. And so I can imagine how frightened she was, number one, worried about protecting us without dad home and worried about if he was going to come home and multiply those stories by the millions. And those are the kind of stories of sacrifice that, not only service members make, but their families as well. And, yeah. And that's just another thing I think about during, Memorial Day and Veterans Day and those days.
Yeah. Philly, listen, before you finale up, I just want for those folks maybe just joining us, the New Directions Veterans Choir. Here they are one more time. Take a listen.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
I needed the shelter of someone's arms. Damn, you were her. I needed someone to understand my ups and downs. Damn, you were her. With sweet love and devotion, deeply touching my emotion. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. Oh yeah.
We are New Directions Veterans Choir, and we're coming in your direction.
How sweet to be loved by you.
The thing I love about those guys too. Another thing I love about those guys is they sing our music, man.
Yeah.
I love those songs. I love those songs.
Fun. Philly, you and I had a good one over the weekend. What did we do? Yeah. It was a little Steve Miller Band.
Yeah, Jet Airliner.
Right. We go Jet Airliner. I got a couple Scott Sucks, Phil, Sing By Yourself. I got a couple of those in there, which, those make my day. It's fine.
Yeah, and there's always going to be haters.
Maybe we'll throw that one up tomorrow night. Great show tomorrow night. Holy cow. We got Vincent Pastore, played Big Pussy on The Sopranos.
Oh, nice.
Vince is coming on. He's in a new movie. We got a guy by the name of Bill Schnee who's coming on tomorrow night. He's one of those behind-the-scenes music producers who recorded every artist you could think of, Phil. So he's going to be great. Great stories. And we'll keep rolling along, man. You want to give us a little final tune here on this Memorial Day program?
Yeah, I will say this. I know, not to be a Debbie Downer here, but, during Memorial Day and July 4th and other patriotic holidays, a lot of times some of the guys and girls that have served, they've got some things going on. They got, some issues that they're still thinking about, and those days may not exactly be a joyous occasion for them, but, and to them, I want to say, hang in there. We love you. Thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you for serving us, mm-hmm. serving your country. And a little tune that goes something like this, and I just want you to think about it. If you need help, reach out. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if I have things you need to borrow, for no one can feel those of your needs that you won't let show. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody. Oh, we all need somebody to lean on.
Nice. Nicely done, my friend. Philly Kid, always a pleasure, my man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, Scotty.
Always a pleasure. Happy Memorial Day to you, you and too. Yours and to, you know, everybody you know that served. All I could say is thanks, right? Because I have no idea what you guys have gone through, and I would never even want to experience it. So I God bless you, my friend.
Thanks, buddy. Appreciate you.
Hit it, baby.
Good night, sweetheart. Oh, it's time to go.
Do, 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 do.
Good night, sweetheart. Oh, it's time to go.
Do, 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 do.
We hate to leave you, but we really must say, oh, good night,
good night,
sweetheart. Good night.